Okay, so we continue with the exercises for derivatives. So number six, we have Audrey is considering an investment in Morgan Communications whose stock currently sells for $60. A put option on Morgan stock with an exercise price of $55 has a market value of 3.06. Meanwhile, a call option on the stock with the same exercise price and time until expiration has a market value of 9.29. The market believes that at the expiration of options, the stock price will be $50 or $70 with equal probability. So what is the premium associated with the put option? And then we have the call option. Okay, so for letter A, so gumawa na lang ako ng parang table na ganito class, no? Para mas madali. So we have the current price, which is 60 for put and call option, and then both also they have the exercise price of 55. Now for the put option, since the current price is 60 and the exercise price is 55, so the put option will not be exercised in that case. So the reason the value is zero. But the market value of the option is 3.06. So the difference is 3.06, which is the option premium. Now for the call option, we have the current price of 60, and then the exercise price is 55. So since in this case, the call option will be exercised. So the difference between the current price and the exercise price is 5. And then you have the market value of option, which is 9.29. So we have the difference, which is 4.29. By the way, the payoff for the long call option is max between ST minus X, no? For the ST, that is the current price or the stock price, minus the exercise price. Now, if the difference between the two is negative, then the value would be zero. Now, the payoff for the long put option is max X minus ST. So again, X is for the exercise price, and ST is for the stock price or the current price, or zero. So if the difference between these two is negative, then the value becomes zero. And we applied that already here, no? So yun na sagot natin for letter A, for the put option, the option premium is 3.06. Now for the call option, the premium is, option premium is 4.29. Now let's go to letter B. So B, ito yan. So if Morgan's stock price increases to $70, what would be the return to an investor who bought a share of that stock? If the investor bought a call option on the stock, and if the investor bought a put option on the stock. Okay, so baba ako, letter B. So we have the price of the stock is at $70 and $55 for the exercise price. Now, if you own the stock, the return would be 10, no? 70 minus 60, so 10, divided by 60. So the return is 16.67%. So may ginti kasi na $10 per share. Now, what if you bought the call option? So if the price of the stock went up to 70 and the exercise price is 55, then you will call the option. So the difference now is 70 minus 55, that is your exercise value of the option. And then actually that is your gain for buying the option. Then divided by 9.29, then minus 1. So the return, rate of return is 61.46%. Now 61.46%. So ang laki ng return, di ba plus? Just imagine, ano? Your cost is only 9.29, but the return is already 61.46. Huh? So, kaya maganda rin ang option. Yun nga lang, pagka medyo napabayaan din yan, medyo, ano, medyo delikado rin, no? For the buy put option, we have 0 all over 3.06. Because in this case, the right to sell will not be exercised. Because why are you going to sell that at 55 when you can sell that at 70? So you will not exercise your right to sell. So your loss for that is only the 3.06. And that is the only loss that you have, 3.06. But of course, that is equivalent to 100%. Because whether the price of the stock goes up or goes down, you have to pay for the premium. And then the maximum loss that you will have would be 3.06, no, per share. Is that clear, class? Is it clear?
Clear, po.
Okay, so for letter C. Okay, letter C tayo. So ito tayo, no? If Morgan's stock price decreases to $50, what would be the return to an investor who bought a share of the stock? So if the investor bought a call option on the stock, and if the investor bought a put option on the stock. So this time the price of the stock decreases to 50. So meron tayo ito, price of the stock at 50, and exercise price is 55. So if you own the stock, now if you own the stock, you will not exercise, own stock pala to, no? Then the stock now goes to 15. So na logika ng $10. $10. So 50 minus 60, $10 negative, divided by 60. So your loss will be 16.67%. Now if you bought the call option, no, bumili ka ng call option, the maximum loss that you'll have will be 9.29%. Kasi you will not exercise your right to buy. Because why will you buy the stock, no, at 55 when you can buy that at 50? So hindi mo siya bibili, di ba? So the reason why the maximum loss that you will have is 9.29, but in terms of percentage, that is 100%. But compared to this one class, di ba? May difference, di ba? Kesa siya binili mo yung stock, tapos yung option, 9.29 naman. E maximum loss mo, 9.29 kung call option niya. So the difference is 0.71. Diba? Nakapag-save ko ng 0.71 kung sakali man, no? So anyway, for the put option, so this time you will exercise your right to sell. Because it is at 55, which is higher than the current price of 50. So 55 minus 50 divided by 3.06 minus 1. So you have 63.40%. Okay, ang laki, no? Biro mo, kung malulugi ka, maximum loss mo is 3.06. Ha? Pero the potential gain is higher, no? For both the call option and the put option. Now let's go to letter D. So letter D, sabi dito, if Audrey buys 0.6 share of Morgan Communications and sells one call option on the stock, has she created a riskless hedge investment? So what is the total value of her portfolio under each scenario? Okay, so ito yung pang-equalize niya. No? Sana, yun lang sana lumabas pang-equalize. Pero tignan natin kung makaka-create siya ng riskless hedge. So letter D, so we have this one, now 0.60, so 0.60 times 50, so 30. So at 50, the value of the option becomes zero, it becomes worthless because it will not exercise to buy the, it will not exercise the right to buy, no, under the call option, kaya zero to, walang cost sa atin yan, no? But if the price goes up to 70 and the exercise price is 55, then the buyer of the call option, not the buyer, kasi tayo yung seller lumalabas dito eh, di ba? The buyer of the call option will exercise his right to buy. So tayo naman, we will sell, no? Kaya lugi tayo dyan. Kasi just imagine selling that stock with a price of 70 at 55. So, lugi tayo ng 15. Okay, meron tayong 15 dito ngayon, negative. No? So, we add them. So, we have 30 plus 0, 30. Then, 42 plus negative 15, So you have 27. Now the question, were you able to create a riskless hedge? The answer is no. Why? Because the value of the portfolio is 30 when the price of the stock goes to 50. And the value of the portfolio is 27 if it goes to 70. So may difference dito, di ba? Dapat equal itong dalawa. O equal yung dalawa. So in that answer, or the answer to that one, it is not a riskless hedge portfolio. Kasi dapat mag-equal yan. Now, let's go to letter E. Letter E. If Aubrey buys 0.75 share of Morgan Communications and sells one call option on the stock, has she created a riskless hedge investment? And what is the total value of her portfolio under each scenario? Okay, so sagot natin sa letter E. So ginawa natin, buys 0.75 shares of stock and then sells one call option. Kumbaga, ito yung ratio niya, di ba? Yan yung ratio niya. So we have 50 times 75, we have 37.50. And then again, at 50, you will not, the party or other party who bought the call option will not exercise the right to buy. So the reason why, on our part, there is no cost. So that's why it is zero. Huh? So 37.50 plus zero, 37.50. Then if the price goes up to 70, so 70 times 0.75, we have 52.50 plus negative 15. Why negative 15 again? Because this time, the other party who bought the call option will exercise his right to buy. So Melo's time now 15 grand. So 52.50 plus the negative 15, so you have now the 37.50. So the value of the portfolio now is 37.50. Whether the price of the stock goes to 50 or the price of the stock goes to 70. The value of the portfolio is 37.50. Pareho lang. So meaning, you are able to create a riskless hedge portfolio. Okay? So that is for number 6. So number 7. So gagawa tayo ng riskless hedge portfolio this time. No? Okay, so sign natin. Stewart Enterprises current stock price is $60 per share. So call options for this stock exist that permit the holder to purchase one share at an exercise price of $50. So these options will expire at the end of 1 year, at which time Stewart stock will be selling at one of two prices, so $45 or $70. The risk-free rate is 7%. As an assistant to the firm's treasurer, you have been asked to perform the following tasks to arrive at the value of the firm's call options. So first requirement, find the range of values for the ending stock price and the call option at the options expiration in 1 year. Okay, so for letter A, we have the ending price, either 45 or 70. So the difference is 25. Now we have the stock strike price of 50. No? Strike price or exercise price, 50. So what is the value of the option for that? So if the option went down to 40, if the price of the stock goes down to 45, then the call will not be exercised. So the reason why the option value is zero. Now if it goes to 70, then the call option will be exercised. So we have the difference of 70 and 50, so 20. So we have now the difference between the two, 45, 70. So we have 25. And then we have 0 and 20, the difference is 20. Okay, so the range now is 25 and 20. Now, so yung range natin. So for letter B, sabi dito, equalize the range of payoffs for the stock and the option. So to equalize that, now we divide 20 and 25. Okay? We divide 20 and 25. So we will get the 0.25 80. Okay, so now we have the ending price again, 45 times 0.80, so we get 36. And then 70 times 0.80, we have 56. So the difference now is 36 and 56 is 20. So the ending option value came from this one, no? So we have now 20. So we are able to equalize the range of payoffs for the stock and the option. Kasi yung ending stock value natin dito 20, ending option value is also 20. So we are able to equalize the range of payoffs, no, for the stock and the option. Now let's create a risk-based hedge investment. And what is the value of the portfolio in 1 year? So hanggang dito pareho lang naman, no? Hanggang dyan pareho lang. So this time we will add the value of the option. So if the price went down to 45, so zero. But if the price goes up or went up to 70, so we have a cost of negative 20. So the difference now between this one is 36, and the difference between this one again is 36. So this time the portfolio now is equal. Now equal na siya. Now equal na siya. So kung equal na yan, ibig sabihin you are able to create now a risk-based hedge. Now for the requirement letter D, what is the cost of the stock? So ito yung ginamit natin, 0.80, because of that one, di ba? And then the price of the stock is $60. So multiply, you get 48. Now the present value of the portfolio is coming from this one. And then divide by 1.07. So the 7 there is the risk-free rate, no? So the present value now of the portfolio is 33.64. So yung difference nito at nito is the price of the option, which is 14.36. Okay? So let's go to number 8. So this one shows you a different format of answering the problem, but actually the process is also the same. But for me, this one, the format for this one is, I believe, is easier, no? Mas okay sa akin to, mas comfortable. So anyway, this one is an option. So you might want to use also this format, no? That I will be showing you. So for number 8, the current price for stock is $50. So in 1 year, the price will be either $40 or $70. So the annual risk-free rate is 4%, and the stock has an exercise price of $55 and expires in 1 year. So find the range of values for the ending stock price and the call option and the option's expiration in 1 year. Then equalize the range of payoffs for the stock and the option. Then create a risk-based hedge investment. And what is the value of the portfolio in 1 year? And what is the cost of the stock in the risk-based portfolio? And what is the present value of the risk-based portfolio? And then the last one is, what is the value of the firm's call option? So actually, in steps ito, pareho lang yung nakaraan, no? In number 7. Okay, so for this one, we have 70 and 40. Kung magiging 70 siya, and then the ending and then the option is 55. So the value now becomes 15 because it will exercise the call option. So 55 tayo dito ngayon, no? And then you have the value is 40. So yung option natin becomes 0 because it will not exercise the right to buy. So we have now the 15 and the 15, 15, 15. So actually, na-equalize na siya pagdating dito, no? Kasi ating ending portfolio value natin, ating option naman natin, so pareho na silang 15, so na-equalize na siya actually pagdating pa lang dyan. The range is 15 over 30, so 0.50. So we will use the buy 0.5 shares and then sell one option, no? And then sell one option. Okay, to create the risk-less hedge, we have now the 70 times 0.5, so coming from here, the 0.5, so we have 35, no? And then minus the 15, because there's a cost, because it will exercise the right to buy. So the ending portfolio value now is 20. And then we have the ending value natin, kung $40 siya, so times 0.5 is 20, then minus the ending option value, which is 0, because the call option will not be exercised. So yung ending portfolio value natin ay 20. So this time, nag-equal na siya, no? Ito na siya, equal na siya. Dito pa lang nga, di ba? Nag-equalize na siya. Dito, kinuha lang pala natin yung range, di ba? But this one, we already equalize the ending portfolio value natin. Because even if it goes up to 70, the portfolio value is already 20. And then if it goes to 40, the ending portfolio value will be 20. So, dyan pa lang, na-equalization natin, no? Pero dito pa lang, makikita nyo na, no? Pagka nag-equal na itong dalawang to, wala nang problema. No? Okay, so, now we can get now the present value of the portfolio. So, since the portfolio value is already $20, so 20 divided by 1.04, so again, the 4 there is the risk-free rate. So, the present value now is 19.23. Now, the current option price, we have the 50 here, which is the price of the stock. And then times 0.5, so you have 25. So, I put in 25. So, 25 minus 19.23. So, you got 5.77 for the current option price. Okay, so that's the end of the exercise 8. Now, stop the recording.